between all who give joy. Jesus is the only giver of joy. And this morning in this house, receive your joy. Receive your joy. Receive your joy. Receive your joy.
Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, I will bless you. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Come on. The next 30 seconds, just say something to the Father. Bless the Lord. Come on, let your lips, let the fruits of your lips bless him. Let the fruits of your lips praise him. Come on, come on, come on. Don't keep quiet. Don't keep quiet. A song that says, I will not be silent. I will always worship. I will always worship. I will always give you praise. That is all. That is what I'm born to do. That is what I am created to do. Is somebody ready to give God some praise this morning? Come on, come on. I'm only feeling the vibe from the choir. I want to feel it from the congregation. Is somebody ready to give God some praise this morning? So, if you're ready, come on, shout yeah! I wanted to forget about your clothes, forget about your shoes, forget about anything, and just do anyhow in the presence of God. The Bible says that David danced to the point that his robe fell off. I'm not saying your clothes should fall off, but just dance to the glory of the Lord this morning. The Lord is great and mighty. The Lord is greatly to be praised. Hey, the Lord reigns. Let the earth tremble. Father, we give you praise. Are you ready? Let's go.
Yahweh is the name, Lord. Yahweh is the name, mighty God.
God.
Yahweh is your name, mighty God.
Oh, you cool is your name, mighty God.
Yahweh is your name, mighty God.
Oh, yeah, Mary is your name, mighty God.
Yahweh is your name, mighty God.
Yahweh is your name, mighty God.
Yahweh is your name, mighty God.
It understands how.
Yo.
You open plenty doors. Lord blesses them, say, make I choose you. Me, they do me like feel you. Now it's the way I get you. Whenever you give me.
Yo.
Let me see you dance for Jesus.
Oh, As if we are not ready, we are not ready. So I'm going to see warming up. Let me see you do like this, do like this. Come on. Oh my God, are we the only ones in church? Come on, do like this. Hey, let me see you jump. I'm going to pray to God. Hey, let me see you wave your handkerchief. Wave your handkerchief. Somebody wave something. Wave something.
So,
let's go. Great are you. Great are you, Lord, the universe is there. Your majesty, who can compare?
Who can compare? I search all over, cause any tone of
great are you, Lord.
Great are you, Lord, the universe is there.
Your
majesty,
who can compare?
Who can compare? I search all over, cause any tone that be
worship your name.
We worship your name, oh God.
We worship your name. King of the universe. We worship your name.
We worship your name. Let me hear everybody here. Come on. We worship.
We worship your name.
Come on, come on. I can't hear your voice. Come on, you can do better than that. Let me hear you. We worship your name.
We worship your name.
Yeah.
King of the universe.
Come on.
We worship your name.
We worship your name.
We worship your name. Yeah. King of the universe.
We worship your name.
We worship your name. King of the universe. We worship your name.
Who has the final say? Bring it on. David. We are saying Alewi Leche. Aleche Lewi. Atoba Jaye has the final say.
So
that is our response. Hallelujah. Are you ready to do with us? I say, who has the final say?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Atoba Jaye has the final say.
Jehovah, Jehovah, Jehovah.
in the head. The God that defends you. Defender of the universe. Provider. The God that provided for you. The God that provided for me.
Hey! 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 ni maze kueme ekueme
ekueme
We are going to do that again one more time. Ekueme
ekueme ekueme
you are the living God. You've done for me.
Hey, hey.
See how you set me free.
Hey,
you are the living God. Ain't there no one like you?
Hey.
You are my healer. You are my helper. My defender. My sustainer.
Yeah, me mother, she me mother, 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 me mother,
the praise.
Yeah.
We're giving God the glory. He's worthy of praise. He's worthy of adoration. He's worthy of praises. If you are not dancing, you are a suspect. Come on.
Yeah.
Give God the glory. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey. 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 Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let me hear you. Say,
when you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner.
Come on, we're dancing now. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Are you dancing? 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 Are you dancing?
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance,
come on, come on, come on. When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner.
Let me see your winning dance. 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 Come on, show your hands up in the air. When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me move, I move like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
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 Is somebody dancing in the house? Hey! Oh, re 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 me oh.
Oh,
re 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 me oh.
Oh, re re re.
If you are dancing to your maker, dance for him like there's no other day. Come on, say,
Ori re re
re me oh.
Ori re re.
Hear this one. Say, when you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, we come dance on, like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance,
hey,
you dance like a winner, man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner, man.
Let me see how they praise, now God I they praise.
Let me see how they praise, now God I they praise.
You are gonna dance up to the sky. You are gonna dance anyhow. Come on, come on, come on. Let me see how they praise, now God I they praise.
Let me see how they praise.
Let me say we dey call on the God we dey praise.
Let me say
we dey call on the God we dey praise.
Let me say we dey praise.
Last one. Come on. Come on. Come on.
I've got joy, 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 joy overflow. In your life.
In my life.
I got joy.
I got joy, joy, joy. Wave those hands, 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 wave those hands. Come on, wave those hands. He who is wise will worship God. He who is wise will worship God. Only a fool will say there's no God. Only a fool will say there's no God. Just wave those hands. Wave those hands, wave those hands, wave those hands, wave those hands. Wave those hands, wave those hands. He has done great things, great things, great things, great things, great things, great things. Da 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 da. Thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jesus. Somebody raise a voice in love. Come on, let's bring the presence of God all over in this room. Lord, we bless your name, we bless your name, we bless your name. We are here to give you praise. We are here to give you all the glory. Cause you are worthy, 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 spirit now. connect to the presence of the Lord.
To his kingdom.
No sound, no sound, no sound, no sound. No sound. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Iba, oh, Iba. 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 Iba, oh. Blessed Ada, son of David. Blessed Ada, root of Jesse.
Ah, shut up.
Blessed Ada, son of David. Blessed Ada, root of Jesse. You are glorious in splendor, immaculately beautiful. I can go on and on, on and on. But my words are not enough. 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 My words are not enough to describe your splendor, to describe your glory. Yes. All I can say is Iba, oh, Iba, hey, hey. Iba, oh, Iba. Iba, oh, Iba. Iba, oh, Iba. Iba, oh, Iba. Everybody say
Iba, oh, Iba.
Iba,
oh, Iba.
Iba, oh,
Iba. Iba,
oh, Iba.
Iba, oh, Iba.
What is the Lamb of God?
Iba, oh, Iba.
Let your worship go up as a sweet smelling savour this morning. The love of God cannot be equated to anything. He's the only one that loves unconditionally. Whether you are doing right or you are doing wrong, He loves you regardless. Even the sinner that has not given his life or her life out there, God still protects them. His love is unconditional. It's an unconditional love. How can you not love that love that was given to you? An unconditional love. But it's been good to me. Oh God, I can't believe how you love me.
What a friend.
He's the best friend you can have. So good to me. Oh God, I can't believe how you love me. It's been good to me. I know. I have seen it time and time and time and time and time again.
So good to me.
Oh God, I can't believe how you love me. Da, 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 da.
What a friend
you are.
Korea Male Masete, Nikabosa, Nikabota, Indana Korea, Maye Malekaba, Indenebo City, Nikabota, Indenebo City, Leka, Ayayayaya, Malikabo City, Indana Korea, Maleada, 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 Yada, 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 Psalm 100 verse 4. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. Psalm 91 verse 1. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will remain secure and rest in the shadow of the Almighty, whose power no enemy can withstand. People of God, your thanksgiving will get you into God's gates. Your praises will get you into his courts. But this atmosphere of worship will get you into the secret place. Now we are in the secret place. In the next few seconds, we're not going to ask anything for ourselves. We are just going to bask in the warmth of his embrace. We are going to bask in the warmth of his embrace. We are going to speak the language of heaven. We are just going to commune with our Father and just let him know how much we love him, how much we appreciate him. Just open your mouth and begin to worship in the spirit. Maleka handa korea, manda vosi talea, inda da da kuria leke, mayanda basata. Like Mosete Yadada, Yahweh Mela, Indana Kuria Baba, Indana Masete, Lekabo Sataya, Ayanda Kuria Leha, Mandibo Sete, Likaba Handa Kuria, Indenebo Leha, Mandabo Sata, Lekabo Setelea, Indenebo Kata, Likaba Handa, Mayenda Basata, Lihanda Kuria, Baskomanos Kumaka Bondala, Lekaba Sataya, Anda Kuria, Mandebo City, Lika Handa, Ey, ay, 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 Masete, 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 Mandebo Liha, Indanada, Lekebo Seteya, Indanada Korea, Ayanda Basata, Yahweh, 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 Rafa, 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 Malelele, Masete, Radada, Malika, Indanada Korea, Melebo Sitaya, Anda Kotoleha, Indanada Kire, Maleka Basata, Leketerebo, Inderebo Sita, Ayanda Korea, Mandela Hata, Lekebo Sotoleha, Indanada Korea, Maliba Sete, Ayadabo, Yadabo, Yadabo, Leka Mahanda, Leka Baba Sete, Leketebo Soto, Lekatanada, Mandibo Leha, Ayanda Korea, Maleka Basata, Lekebo Seteya, Indana Baba Korea, Lahanda Bosita, Lekebo Sete, Leyanda Korea, Lehanda Korea, Lehanda Bakoria, Lehanda Bakoria, Lehanda Bakoria, Lehanda Bakoria, Lehanda Bakoria. Oh, ya, 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 Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh. Rafa Elohim. Shaddai, ay, 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 Jireh, Adonai, si manifesta kum, ayadabo sitaneta. Saints of God, sing, Yahweh, Rapha, ay, ay,
ay,
Elohim. Jehovah El Shaddai, Jireh, Jireh, Adonai, Adonai, si manifesta ko, ayadabo sitaleka, mandibo lekebo, Yahweh, 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 Rafa. Tonight, Seteya, Manda Korea Leata, Yahweh, 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 Yahweh. Manifest yourself.
Yeah.
Come manifest yourself. Come manifest yourself. Holy Spirit of God, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, come manifest yourself. Manifest yourself. Manifest yourself. This is my cry. This is our desire. Manifest yourself.
Come manifest yourself.
Jehovah Elohim.
Come manifest yourself.
Jehovah El Shaddai.
Come manifest yourself.
Jehovah Sikeno.
Come manifest yourself.
Come manifest, come manifest yourself.
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 Ay, 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 Luke chapter 18 verse 1. Now Jesus was telling the disciples a parable to make the point that at all times they ought to pray and not to give up and lose heart. The King James Version says men ought to pray and not to faint. The Bible says also they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This place of intimacy is a place of rest. The longer you stay in the place of prayer, the stronger a believer you are. For the next few seconds, you're going to open your mouth and you're going to pray. You're going to pray whatever it is that the Spirit of God lays in your heart. I don't know what you've come with as a burden, but the King of Kings is here. It is time to speak to Him. It is time to communicate your feelings, your emotions, your needs, your wants to Him, and surely He will hear you. Radabo seta laya in da kuria malekebo sete ayadaba sete ayadaba kuria lekebo sataya in derebo sata mandila handa lekaba handa baba eyadaba sata in da kunda likaba sata leya. I will pray. I will pray. Aya baba. I will pray, I will pray. In the basete, I will pray, I will pray. In the rebole kababa, I will pray, I will pray. Manda baseta, neke bobo sata ya da da da. If I were you, I would not shut my mouth. A closed mouth is a closed destiny. The child of God who does not have the attitude of opening their mouth in prayer, the devil will make mess of them. I will pray. I will pray. I will pray, y'all. I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me. I will pray, I will pray, I will pray, oh, I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me. So I refuse. Never again.
Never again.
Never again. Will Satan make mess of me. Fire. So I refuse. So I refuse. That's why my mouth is open. That's why my mouth is open. I refuse. I refuse. Never again. We Satan make mess of me. I will pray. Come on.
I will pray. I will pray. I will pray.
Abba, Satan, I am.
If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me.
Let me see the one who does not want to be made mess of.
I will pray.
Male Baba Setele Kahanda. Leyadabo Setele Katalada. Satan, enough is enough for ya. Malika Basetayada. Mayanda Kuria Lekahanda. Radabo Setele Kete. Indarada Kuria Mahanda Bosete. I take back everything you have taken from me. I take back everything that God's will has availed to me that you have taken. You have no right to take what God has availed to me. For the thoughts of God toward me, they are thoughts of good, they are thoughts of peace, they are not thoughts of evil. So give me an expected end. You cannot twist my destiny. You cannot change my story, Satan. Therefore, everything that God's will has accrued unto me, I appropriate it to myself, because I have believed that I have been given all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. I convert them now to my reality. Where Christ says I am healed, I cannot be sick. Where Christ says I have been made rich, I cannot be poor. Where Christ says I've been lifted up, I cannot be put down. Nobody can decree a thing and it will come to pass when Jehovah has not said it. Therefore, anything that has been said, anything that has been decreed that Jehovah did not say by himself, I cancel it and nullify it. I will pray. I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me. There was a woman in scripture. This woman was so ill, was so sick. She had gone everywhere, but she found no cure. She had spent all her money, but there was no cure. Anytime they told her there was a miracle doctor somewhere, she would take the air cash that she had and she would go and meet that miracle doctor, and it will be futile. 1 year went into 2 years. 2 years went into 3 years. 3 years went into 4 years. She was bleeding profusely and continuously. Her condition became her identity. Her condition became what they called her. Even the Bible calls her the woman with the issue of blood. Some of us, the devil has put us in conditions that have become our identity. Rather than they call us by the name God called us, they call us by the condition Satan has imputed on us. I am angry. I am angry. I am angry. How can they call me what my father has not called me? How can they give me a name my father in heaven has not given me? They called her the woman with the issue of blood. 4 years became five. 5 years became six. 6 days became seven. Some of you are sitting down here and looking at me. You are in that same condition. But I don't know whether it's your pride or your ego. You won't open your mouth and cry out. 8 years became nine. 9 became 10. 10 became 11. 11 became 12. And one day, she heard that Jesus was passing by. And she said to herself, if only I can touch the hem of his garment. Now we see that prayer as a prayer of faith.
But let me tell you, that prayer came from a place of desperation. She knew she was too smelly, that if she wanted to see Jesus, probably nobody would let her. So she said, if only I can touch the hem of his garment, Lord, I believe I'll be made whole. She believed it with her heart. She confessed it with her mouth. And then she stepped into action. I don't know what you believe in God for today. I don't know what made you take that step of faith to come into this tabernacle today. But all you need is just faith enough to say, Lord, if I can touch the hem of your garment. And he's here. He's here. He's here. Come here, she's here. Oba is here. Eledu Marie is here. Arubo Ojo is here. The one who sees and knows all things is here. All you need to do is a little faith. Touch me with your hands, Jesus. Touch me with your hands, Jesus. Touch me with your hands, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Touch me with your hands, Jesus. I don't wanna go the same way I came. Touch me with your hands. Touch me with your hands. Lord, I don't wanna go. I don't wanna go with this pain. I don't wanna go back with this infirmity. I don't want to go back with this situation. I don't want to go back with this story. I don't want to go back with this condition. I don't want to go back with this travail. I don't want to go back with this identity. Jesus, I don't want to go the same way I came. Touch me with your hands. Touch me with your hands. I don't wanna go.
I don't wanna go
back the same. Touch me with your hands. Touch me with your hands. Come on, touch me, Lord. Let's sing.
Touch me with your hands.
Ayadaba setale kabababa.
Touch me with your hands.
Maleva seta yadababa lika. Touch me with your hands.
Touch me with your hands.
Ayababa lika bosa taya.
Touch me with your hands.
Leka bosa taya dada.
Jesus,
I don't wanna go.
I don't wanna go
the same way I came. Touch me with your hands.
Touch me with your hands.
Touch me with your hands, oh God.
Jesus,
I don't wanna go.
I don't wanna go.
I don't wanna go with this condition. Touch me with your hands.
Touch me with your hands.
Touch me with your hands.
Jesus.
I reiterate, that woman said, Lord, if only I can touch the hem of your garment. If only I can touch the hem of your garment. The beautiful thing is that she did not just say it. She made the steps to do it. So when Jesus was passing, she stretched forth her hand with all her might and she touched the hem of his garment. And the Bible said immediately she was made whole. I stretch forth my hands. I touch you now. I stretch forth my hands. I touch you now.
Touch you.
I stretch forth my hands. I touch you now.
Yeah.
I stretch forth my hands. I stretch forth my hands. Say,
I stretch forth my hands.
Yes, Lord.
I touch you now.
Yes, Lord.
I stretch forth my hands.
Yes, Lord.
I touch you now.
Have mercy on me.
I stretch forth my hands.
Yes, Lord.
I touch you now.
Have mercy on me.
I stretch forth my hands.
I stretch forth my hands.
I stretch forth my hands.
I am a baleha.
I touch you.
Mande baleke terara. Mande mosita yada. Lika mosete. Inda la la da kuria. Leke mosita
yada. Inda la
la da da.
I stretch forth my hands.
I stretch forth my faith. I touch you now. I stretch forth my faith. I touch you now. I stretch forth my faith. I touch you now. I stretch forth my faith. I stretch forth my faith. Say,
I stretch forth my faith. I touch you now.
I am a baleha.
I stretch forth my faith.
Malika bosa.
I touch you now.
In da 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 da
kure. I stretch forth my faith.
Eya da bosi.
I touch you now.
In da 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 da
kure.
I stretch forth my faith.
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 Malika bosa. Eya da bosi teya. In da 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 kure. Leka bosa teya. Mande bosi teya. In da 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 kure. Leka bosa teya ya. Mani baleke bota. In da 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 kure ya ba. Leka yanda kire. Kana mosi atata. Leka bosa ya da da da. Yeshua HaMashiach, Lion of Judah, Agune Chemba, let me hear you say,
Yeshua HaMashiach,
Ayanabosi Taleka,
Lion of Judah,
Ayanabasi Taleka Bota,
Agune Chemba.
Yeshua say,
Yeshua,
I am a baleya taba, Mandi mole kabo sataya, Adada bali kabo yada, Yeshua, Yeshua, Yeshua,
Yeshua,
Indada da da kuria le kabo ta, Mandi mo sete le kabo tiata, Indada da da kuria le kabo ta. Yeshua, Yeshua, Yeshua,
Yeshua,
ay, 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 Lion of the tribe of Judah,
Agune Chemba,
Yeshua, Yeshua, Yeshua,
Yeshua,
Seta, Leketebo Sata, Endalana Koya Lekabota, ay, 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 ay. God who opened the Red Sea.
Oh, yes.
You are the God who opened the Red Sea.
Oh, yes.
You are the God.
You are the God.
You are the God.
You are the
God. Say,
Yeshua.
Yeshua. Lion of the tribe of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
I go, the chamber. One more time, one more time, one more time. You are the God who parted the Red Sea. You are the God who parted the Red Sea. You are the God. You are the God. You are the God. Say,
yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah. You reign, you ancient Zion's King, Kadosh, Kadosh. You are mighty on your throne. Come on, holy fire, lift your voice and declare and say,
you reign, you ancient Zion's King,
Kadosh, Kadosh.
You are mighty.
You reign, you reign, you reign.
You reign,
you reign,
you reign,
you reign,
you
reign,
you reign,
you reign,
you reign,
you reign, you reign, Adonai, Elohim.
You reign,
you reign,
you reign,
you reign. yes, you reign, you reign, ay 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 ay, only God is higher. What I hear, I'm not moved by what the devil says. I'm only moved by the word of God. Come on, everybody say amen. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, amen, amen, amen. Kosi agbara, to dabi ti Jesus. Holy fire, lift your voice and say,
Kosi agbara,
to dabi ti Baba,
to dabi ti Baba,
Kosi agbara,
Kosi.
Let the sound of rejoicing.
mande de le ketere de bosaya enda la la da korea le ya da 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 kire bale ke boseta ayana korea mala ende de bosoto de ha enda la la da korea le kababa enda la la seta ya ya le kabosiana.
Put our hands together for Jesus one more time. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed is God's name. Hallelujah. Can I invite you to lift up your voices this morning and give God all the glory and praise? Thank the Lord for all his workings in your life. I appreciate God for his grace. Bless the Lord for keeping you alive, watching over you, and refusing the works of darkness to prevail over your lives. Thank the Lord for divine supplies. Thank the Lord for meeting your needs. Thank the Lord for hearing your prayers when you cry to God. Thank the Lord in the midst of confusion, God speak and quell all forms of confusion. Thank the Lord when you are in trouble, he delivers you from trouble. Thank the Lord who will never allow you to be destroyed in any form, even when the enemy raises a mighty standard. He raises a higher standard to destroy the works of darkness. Open your mouth and appreciate the Lord. Many are the workings of the Lord in your life. There are things you don't know that the Lord is doing on your behalf. Open your mouth and appreciate God for all of those things. Blessed is God's name. Thank the Lord for your loved ones that God has preserved because of you. Because of you. There are a lot of people that God is preserving because of you. He has not allowed shame to come near them because you have been interceding on their behalf. So thank the Lord. This morning, blessed is God's name. Thank you, Jesus. I also know that this past week the enemy raised all kinds of evil standards. But the Lord dealt with them because of the fact that he loves us. And there's a covenant of peace that he has with us. He will not allow anything to bring shame to us in any form. So let's appreciate the Lord. Thank you, Father. Blessed is your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Everlasting Father, Father of grace, we thank you because we have you. You are the one that have always made the difference in our lives. In the midst of difficulties, in the midst of troubles, you are always there. In the times of need, you've always shown yourself mighty, awesome, and powerful. This morning we are gathered in this house, Lord, to worship the able God. We all know who you are, except we deceive ourselves. There is no human being on the surface of this earth who doesn't know there's one God that exists in the heavens. Except when our heart deceives us or we allow the enemy to deceive us. So we know there's a God that dwells in the heavens and makes this earth his footstool. We know there's a God that reigneth in the affairs of men. We also know there's a God that answered prayer, unto him shall all flesh be gathered. So we are gathered in this house, O Lord, because you are a prayer answering God. Because you are a God that attends to the needs of your own children. We thank you, Father, for being a good father to us. We thank you for saving us, delivering us from the works of darkness and the powers of hell. We thank you because you will not allow the enemy to eat us raw. You don't allow the enemy to dig a grave and allow us to go into that grave. You will not allow us to see shame. You will fight for us every time and give us victory over our enemies. And so, Lord, we thank you this morning for all of your mighty good works upon our lives. Blessed is your holy name. And as we come in thanksgiving, Lord, we commit this service into thy hands. We invite you to come and reign in a mighty way this morning and to exalt the name of Jesus, your only begotten Son, that every one of us in this house today, we have a taste of his goodness, a taste of his mercies, a taste of his graciousness, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, as you bring healing to those who are sick, strength to those who are weak, and deliver those who are afflicted in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says you sent your word and your word healed them and delivered them from their destruction. Let healing come to somebody this morning in the name of Jesus. Let anyone that the enemy has a mark to destroy, let that one be delivered as you did unto your servant. Blessed is your holy. If there's anything hidden that our eyes cannot see, Lord, reveal them to us in the name of Jesus, so that our lives are spared and our, Lord, our future defined in your will, not in the will of the enemy, not in our personal will. Thank you, our Father. Blessed is your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. And everybody in this house, say aloud, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Can you celebrate the Lord again with the hand clap, please, if you can? Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. We are serving him. What a mighty God we serve. Come on, somebody. Heaven and earth adore, even angels bow before him. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Somebody now. Mighty God, indeed we serve. May I invite you to take your seat, powerful principalities and powers. Glory be to God. You are welcome to church this morning, and I pray that the Lord will do you so good this morning. Thank you, Jesus. I'd like you to turn your Bibles to the book of Matthew, chapter 25, verse 33. And I'd like to read God's word. Matthew chapter 25, verse 33. The Bible says there, and he shall set the sheep, know that word, on the right hand. And he said, but the goats on the left. I repeat the word. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. As we're getting ready for the mighty season of the Passion of Christ, this season of Easter, which is very close to us, it is important to realize what this season is all about, even as we prepare for it. The Bible says in the book of John, chapter 3, verse 16, that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Thank you so much.
If you look at verse 15 of that same scripture, the Bible says that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. The word of God made us understand that there are two types of places or two types of people, those that will perish and those that will have eternal life. The book of John chapter 3 verse 16 makes us understand that there is those who will perish and those who will have eternal life. If you look at John chapter 3 verse 19, the Bible says, in the rest of the scripture that talks about light and darkness. So there are two types of lights on the earth. Light and what? And darkness. He said that the light is come into the world and men love darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil. I know that word. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 25 verse 41, it talked about those who are cursed. He used the word, there are those, he used the word, ye are cursed into everlasting fire. So there are people that God has created, but they are here on earth who are cursed. And the Bible said there's a curse hanging on their heads, and that curse will lead them to hellfire. He used the word everlasting fire. I'd like you to note that word. So there are those who are cursed and are those who are blessed. As we're sitting down here in this morning in this house, I pray to God that you are not going to be one of them who are cursed. Because every man that is cursed will end up in hellfire. The Bible used the word everlasting fire. Are you there, somebody? That worries me. That as we are all here on earth, there are those who are damned to go to hell and those who are blessed to go to heaven. And I want to be one of them, and I pray to God that you likewise desire to be one of those people who are blessed, who will end up where? In heaven. There is everlasting life to be made. And where that everlasting life dwells is with God in heaven. I'd like to read you two scriptures before I begin to amplify God's word. First, John chapter 14, verse 2 to 4. Look at that scripture with me. John chapter 14. John chapter 14, verse 2. The Bible says, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, note that word, and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. And then he said, use the word, and whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. As we are sitting down here, it is important you have this understanding in your heart that there is a place that God has prepared for me and you where we ought to be someday. Amen. And the only people that can be in that place, the Bible used the word, they are the ones that God has kept in his right hand. And I pray I'm going to explain that to you and you'll get it clear. Bible says, every man that is a sheep, God has brought each one of them to dwell with him by his right hand. And he now said, those of them who are going to hell, they are the ones he has put in where? The left hand. That will not be your portion. So the theme, the topic of this message, it is right and left. Everybody use that word. Let me hear you say that word. Right and left. Say it again. Right and left. There are those of us in this house who are on the right hand side of God. And there are others on the left hand side of God.
My prayer is that you must never be found in the left-hand side of God. Because anywhere you find people by the left-hand side, they are all referred to as what? Goats. They are not sheep. The Bible called them, they are cursed. So anybody you see sitting at the left-hand side of God is what? Is cursed. Is not blessed. Only those who are found at the right-hand side of God is what? Is blessed. And the Bible referred to them as sheep and goats. So there are two types of people. There are sheep and there are goats. The question is, are you a sheep or you are a goat? The reason why Jesus came into this world is to make sure that everybody at the left-hand side come to the right-hand side. I think here somebody say amen. So why Jesus came here, everybody was at the left-hand side. There was nobody at the right-hand side. By the way, the only person at the right-hand side is himself. The only person at the right-hand side of God is what? It's Jesus. Jesus himself. Only him. The Bible used the word, is the only begotten of God. Hallelujah. So before we came, all of us were where? We are on the left-hand side. But some of us have moved from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. And I pray to God, if you find yourself here, you need to move here. I didn't hear somebody say amen. So Easter, as we're about to celebrate the Passion of Christ, the death and the resurrection of Jesus, that death and resurrection only did one thing, to move people from one side to the other side. I didn't hear somebody. Amen, somebody. To move people from where? The left to the right. And I pray to God, if you find yourself on the left-hand side, God will change your position today. Throughout this season of Easter, we'll be ministering on how to move you from this side. Because we need to move from this side. All of us must come here. Am I talking to somebody? If you are left here, I will open your eyes and show you where you are going to end up. You need to work hard to leave this position and come to this position. Every one of us today are working hard to leave the position of poverty to prosperity. Do you know that? Do you know that? Everybody living in one room is trying to have two rooms. And those who are living in two rooms are trying to have three rooms. And those who are living in three rooms are trying to have a duplex to themselves. Come on, somebody down. Man is always looking for the best bargain, the best deal. You drive a car today and tomorrow you want a better car. You want to change your vehicle to something better. There's nothing wrong with that. That's the reason why you need to move from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. If you desire something better in your life, there is nothing better than the right-hand side. Oh, come on, somebody in the house of God. Hallelujah, somebody there. Do you remember those days when we're driving vehicle, the left-hand side vehicle? Do you remember that? Did you ever drive a left-hand side vehicle? Wave your hand, somebody. Did you ever see a man that used to drive a vehicle on the left-hand side? Abraham Obuba remembers that. Maybe stand on your feet, let me hear you. Did you see people used to drive vehicle on the left-hand side? How does it look? It's always awkward. No, even then it was never good. It was never good. We took that from the British. Okay, it's one of the colonial benefits. I don't call it benefits, it's a cost. One of the things that the colonial masters gave to us. I wish we can change everything that they gave to us and do something better. So, anyway, recently, just about 15 years ago, I was driving a left-hand side vehicle. One of my cousins imported it from England. It is Toyota Avensis. You remember that vehicle? Amen. And so when you bring it to Nigeria, the law says you must change it to the right-hand side. Oh my God. I hope somebody will change to the right-hand side. It costs some money to change to the right-hand side, okay? So to change that vehicle, you need to spend some amount of money to convert it. So there's what we call converting. There are people, there are engineers in Lagos here that knows how to convert that vehicle from left-hand side to right-hand side. That is when you become compliant, when you change from the left to the right. There's only one person that knows how to do this business. His name is Jesus. Right? He's the only engineer that can change from the left to the right. And you don't have to pay any cover. It is free to change from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. There's a particular song that we used to sing in church. Come. Oh, to the right hand side. Come on, I like to. Can choir pick me a microphone and sing this song with me? Come on, somebody. Let us sing it. Everybody stand. Choir, can you please lead me in that song? One more time. Come on, somebody. The song simply says we should all move on to where? To the right hand side. I'm sweating. Please give me the fans. I know you don't want me to use them, but please. Hallelujah. The song says we should do what? All of us should do what? Move on to the right hand. I know that. Just put it. I'll try to manage. Or give me one if you can. I know it affects it, but I'm sweating. I just can't. Thank you. Glory be to God. So this journey is about the left and work, and the right. And so, if that is the case, everything every human being on earth should desire is how to move from the left-hand side and move where? To the right-hand side. Because everything that God has is only for them who are on the right-hand side. And every other thing that is not desirable is what God has kept for them who are where? On the left-hand side. And you can never be there. What did I say? You can never be there. Now, look at the book of Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20, as we look at more of the scriptures. Ephesians chapter 3, no, Philippians more or less. Philippians chapter 3, verse 20. The Bible says, for our conversation is in heaven, from where also we look for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. I'd like you to notice that word. Our conversation is what? In heaven. From where also we look for where? Look for who? Our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible is trying to make us understand exactly the Master, the one we call our Master, our Lord and Savior. His dwelling place is where? Heaven. Okay? God's dwelling place is where? Heaven. Jesus' dwelling place is where? Heaven. So anybody that is looking up to Jesus is a heavenly candidate. Amen? Because that's the only way you can find him. You cannot find Jesus in hell. Okay? So if you are in church and the reason why you are here is to have communion, relationship with Jesus, there's only one direction. The heavenly places. Can I hear somebody say amen? And the heavenly places are only meant for them who are on the right-hand side. Why? He called them his sheep. That I've kept all my sheep by my right-hand side. Okay? And the only person that can be with God is he that is found where? On the right-hand side. So every man that wants to be with God must be looking out for Jesus, the Savior. And the Savior can only be found where? Heaven. Okay? If Jesus is found in heaven, where then is the devil found? on the left hand side. And on the left hand side, we call it a hellish experience. So anyone that is on the left hand side is going to find himself in the pit of hell where Satan dwells, because there is no dwelling place for Satan in heaven. If you read the book of Revelation from chapter 12 from verse 7 down, the Bible says he was thrown where? He was thrown into the bottomless pit, that is hell. His place was no more found in heaven. So scripture says that the place of Satan was no more found where? In heaven. So anybody that wants to make hell, anybody that wants to be with Satan, you already know where you are going to. So there is what we call heaven. There's also what we call hell. There's what we call the left-hand side. There's what we call the right-hand side. And what we call what? The left-hand side. There's what we call light. There's also what we call darkness. Can I hear somebody say amen? So it is divided into two. Okay? Life itself is divided into what? Two. And whether you like it or not, you need to belong to one side. You cannot belong to both sides. Can I hear somebody say amen? We cannot do what? We cannot belong to both sides. You need to be in a particular side. Simple. So you that is looking forward to be saved of God, heaven is only your concentration. Can I hear somebody say amen? We are here so that we don't perish. We are here saved from the world so that someday we'll find ourselves with who? With our God. Don't deceive yourself. I said to somebody a few days ago, anything God said I do, I will do. I don't care who you are. I don't care whatever covenant I have with you, whatever agreement I have, whatever, anything I've done with, proposal, anything I've done with you. Once God said to me, son, this is it, that's the end. I cannot please any human being on this earth and displease God. Yes, it will never happen. Never. Even if I've sold my heart to you, even if I've given you my life, I will disappoint you. Listen to me, and I'm serious when I say this to you. I am ready to disappoint anybody on this earth because of God. The Bible said the coming of Christ is to separate fathers from their children, children from their parents. Why? There's a decision to make. And that decision might mean your separation. I didn't hear somebody say, man. Separation from who? From the people you love. Are you there? Yes. Have this at the back of your mind. Let no man in this world fool you to accept anything from them and disobey your God. Anything your God says do, that's where you stand. Even though you have signed any paper, tear it. You didn't hear what I'm saying? Did you hear what I said? Even though you have signed any document, any document, take it and destroy it. Why? The one that will destroy your soul is more important than the one that will destroy your name. Oh, he's a wicked man. He has done this all because you took a decision. Let them call you any name, because the one that will destroy your soul is worse than the one that will destroy your name. I accept for my name to be destroyed, but I will never allow my soul to be destroyed. Withdraw from any engagement if it does not please God. Why? It is more dangerous for you to say no to God and say yes to a human being. And I tell you the reason why. Only God knows the heart of man. The man you say yes to might betray you tomorrow. The God you say yes to will never betray you. The Bible says, the rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You can't seek God and God reward you evil. So note this right now. Stay at the right hand side and reject anything from the left hand side. I didn't hear you say something there. Did you hear what I said? Stay where? And reject what? Anything from the left hand side. People might not like your decisions. People might be angry at the things you have decided to do, but in as long as you did them under God's instruction, as long as you did them because God said so, friend, you have just moved from the left-hand side to the right. I am not going to stay with them at the left-hand side. If you can join me to say that word. Say it again with your mouth. I am never going to stay with them at the left hand side. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16 and 17. Then I'm going to go back to the book of Matthew where we are going to spend quality time. And then Matthew 25, more or less. So let's look at this. 1 Thessalonians. Thank you, Jesus. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16 and 17. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a loud shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. And look at 17. Then we, which are alive and remain, shall be caught up together with them in the cloud to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Know that word. So shall we ever be with the Lord. If there's anybody in this house who is desiring to be with God, if you are here and your desire is to be with God someday, I have a word with you for you. I beg you in God's name, remember this word, that the Lord is going to descend someday. He's coming back. I didn't hear somebody talk to me. What did I say? He's coming back again. Remember, he was born of the Virgin Mary. He's not coming back born of any Virgin Mary. The Bible says he's going to descend, right? From the heavens. He's not descending from hell. Are you there? From where is he descending? He's coming from the top, not from the bottom. Amen? Hell is under us. Heaven is above us. So we're not looking down. We're looking up. So he's coming. So everyone that is in this house this morning looking up towards God coming, you should be looking at the heavens. It means our relationship with God is all about looking. Looking up. Looking at when he's going to come. I mean, all activities, everything we do should be directed at what? Our desire to make heaven. I didn't hear somebody say amen. As we're about celebrating Easter, let's have this at the back of our mind. This is about eternity. Nothing else. Jesus died because he wants you to move from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. He has translated you from the pit of hell to the kingdom of his Father. The heavenly places, the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, that's where God wants you to be. And make no mistake about it. It's either you want to be there or you don't want to be there. That is your portion. I just, this morning as I was getting ready to come to church, I was entering into my bathroom to take my bath after I've finished my study. And then something came up on television. It's a young man that was doing well in England and fell in love with a woman in Ukraine on the internet. And then he went to Ukraine to see this beloved friend that he fell in love with on the internet. And somehow, within 3 months, he decided to marry this girl. Okay? And then began to sell everything he has in England and bought a house of $200,000 in Ukraine. Never knew that he was dealing with a fraudster who claimed to be a lover. The house that was bought was $60,000 instead of $200,000. So the girl was lying to this man all this while. Okay? And then at the end of the day, the laws in Ukraine does not allow this lady to just quickly leave Ukraine and come to England. So there's a lot of immigration documentation that needs to be obtained. So guess what the man did? Since the laws in England permit him to relocate anywhere he wants to go to, he packed all, sold everything he has in England and moved to Ukraine. Everything he had, sold everything, and moved to Ukraine. Guess what? That girl had a plan in place. He knew that he was a millionaire and wanted to scam him of every dime he has. And that's what she did. Right? Pretended to love this man, because that's what men do. We pretend. It takes the grace of God for you to
to identify a pretender. And all of us in this church, there are so many pretenders here. Am I talking to somebody? The only person you cannot pretend to is God Almighty. Why? He is your creator. He knows your heart. He knows who you are. You cannot pretend to him. This man never knew that this girl that claimed to love him has been pretending. The marriage that was done in Ukraine, 60 people sitting down there were hired. His mother-in-law was hired. Give me my microphone. Give me something there. Before he arrived in Ukraine, the person he claimed to be, her mother was never her mother. Everybody were Nollywood people hired. They were playing Nollywood. This is all drama. Out of the money that he has transferred to buy a house in Ukraine, he has used the money to hire a lot of people. So the day of the marriage, including the pastor, everybody was hired. And this foolish man does not know that he walks into a trap. So to him, he has found love. To him, the whole world has come to him. He's on top of the world. Sold everything he had in England because of the deception of a woman. And finally, the woman was already planning to kill him. The best man happened to be the real boyfriend. he married the boy before he married this man. And then produced a divorce certificate because he had told a lie that, I'm divorced. So he had to produce a divorce. So married and divorced and produced the certificate. So to him, divorce. British man, foolish man, does not know that the best man is the real husband of the woman is getting married. Then what happened? Every money that was brought into Ukraine by this man, they converted all. By the way, they lied to him that himself cannot own an account. So the money must be in the woman's account. You know, there's sometimes when you love, you believe everything. Are you there? When you love a woman, what do? You believe everything. Even as they are leading you to the slaughterhouse, you follow them until they cut off your neck. And there are some women too like that. They love men. Once they find out that you have money, they come and they disguise themselves. They will kiss your feet and kiss your butt, kiss your guts, and all they are preparing for is to swindle your life. So this is what happened to this man. But the truth is, as they were planning to take his life, he found out by somebody who had been curious about what is going on. So what's going on? How come this man is blind, cannot see what they are doing to him? That person was the one that had let out the secrets. But before then, everything is gone. Every money is gone. Lady has disappeared into thin air. Can't find the girl anymore. Foolish British man went back to England, cobbleless, robbed, had nothing. Let me tell you something about deception. A lot of people are going to be deceived to go to hell. And I pray you not be one of them.
Amen.
Deception is always very sweet. But the end is destruction. Can I hear somebody say amen?
Amen.
One of the greatest evil that can happen to a man is a man being deceived, or a human being being deceived. And that's what the devil does. He's the master of deception. If he was able to take one third of the angels in heaven, you know who he is. He was able to deceive one third of angels in heaven to rebel against God. So we are dealing with a guy who is the master deceiver. He knows what to say to get you on his side. And I pray to God he will not get you on his side.
Amen.
I didn't hear somebody say amen there.
Amen.
What did I say? The devil, say it with your mind, the devil is not going to get me on his side. Say it again with your mouth. The devil is not going to get me on his side. I refuse to be on the left-hand side. Oh, can I hear you say that word? I refuse to be on the left-hand side. I will remain where? On the right-hand side. Don't be deceived to pack your load and go here. May God help me and you. Let me show you some things. And by the grace of God, when we leave church today, our mind will focus on the heavenly places. We are not going to join them on the left-hand side and allow our lives to be ruined. Can I hear you say amen? Don't worry. Some of us will have made wrong decisions in time past. Everybody on the left-hand side made a wrong decision. But one thing about God, after you've made your wrong decisions, he wants you to come to the right-hand side. Okay? Yes, you are on the left-hand side, but somehow, you end up here. And I'll tell you one man who did the same thing. And how God was able to smuggle him, regardless of the fact that he was supposed to be on the left-hand side, he ended up on the right-hand side and found himself in the heavenly places. May God help all of us. Matthew chapter 5, verse 3. Now, that's the scripture that speaks to every man that wants to be on the right-hand side. And this is what that scripture says. Scripture we all know, but it's better, let's open and read. So simple. He said, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. The poor in spirit are them who are on the left-hand side. Because if you are poor in the spirit, it means you lack understanding of the things of the spirit. And when you lack the understanding of things of the Spirit, what happens is that, believe me, you're a weak Christian that would definitely end up where? End up in hell. But guess what the Bible says? That regardless of the fact that you are poor in spirit, your place is still where? Heaven. It means you can walk yourself out of that spiritual stagnancy. And this is what I pray today will happen to all of us. Are you there? You need to walk yourself out of where you find yourself. Okay? Use the word retrace your steps. Don't follow the enemy into the pit of hell. You already know that this journey is going to end up terribly. Make up your mind never to be there and make up your mind to change position. Can I hear you say amen there? All of us in this house, we have a decision to make. Do we remain where we are or do we work hard and come to the other side? And everybody this morning that is listening to the sound of my voice, yes, I am poor in the spirit, but I'm not going to allow my spiritual recklessness to destroy my life. Somehow I must find my way out of where I find myself. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Now, one of the problems that happen to a lot of business people is that they make wrong decisions, and instead of them to retrace that step and go back, they don't want to do that. Why? Ego is one, pride is another. I read one news on the internet and it bothers my heart. It's the MD and CEO of Erico Foods who make tomato paste. Okay? This is a man that has a very great company, doing well. Unfortunately, somebody bought one of his products. And while the woman was cooking in the kitchen, he noticed that the product has a problem. He took the tomatoes and tested it and found out the sugar, that the thing is too sweet, right? And understand that tomato cannot be as sweet as this. Something happened to these tomatoes. Unfortunately for her, she put it on Facebook, because there are some of you here, you are internet freaks. You love internet. Some of you can't even depart from your telephone. Every moment, hour, you're on your phone. Some of you here, your hand is always It's like the devil has put your hand on the telephone. Yes, some people, they are even on telephone till 3 a.m. in the morning. Are you there? They don't sleep. They are always on the phone. One of the biggest problems you have in marriages today is the telephone. Some people are married to their phone. Even when their husband is talking, they are not listening. If the wife is talking, they are not listening. Their mind is, what is coming out of the telephone? So, oh, tomorrow we are going to travel. He's not listening to travel. He's listening to what? So, but what did I say? I didn't hear you. What did you say? Did you say? The telephone is the best friend. Some people today, their husband is no more their best friend. Their telephone is their best friend. This telephone, we thank God for it, but now it's causing a lot of trouble. Do you understand what I'm saying? Big problem. So that woman carried all the tomatoes and then took his phone and snapped the tomatoes and put it on his Facebook page and said, my God, this tomatoes is killing people. So, the owner of this company got to know that somebody, Ngozi or whatever it is, has posted some terrible information on his product. So he got angry, went to the police, that this person has broken the law and wanted this woman to be arrested. And sure, you know, Nigerian police, they arrested this woman and took this woman for interrogation and kept her there for a long period of time. And she's a nursing mother and also a wife to a wonderful man. So the husband went into action trying to save the wife from the police station, and the police were not having none of it. They even carried her from Lagos to Abuja, where they locked her up. Why? She lives in Lagos. Those are some of the laws in this country that must change. How do you carry somebody? That happened to me. Somebody went to somebody petitioned Inspector General of Police in Abuja against me. And then people travel all the way from Abuja to Lagos to come and serve me paper in my office. I was shocked. So you people came all the way from Abuja and said, yes, the offense is so serious that you people have to travel all the way from Abuja to come to Lagos, three of you, to come and carry me. So I said, can you people go back to Abuja? I'll come on the date you have put here. So on that particular day, before that date, I made some investigations to find that I could ask them, who is the person that wrote this petition? I said, we will never tell you. When you come to Abuja, that's when we will tell you. I said, but how can I walk into a trap without knowing what I'm walking into? So I got my men to go and investigate. When they investigated, I now find the person. The same Balogun family who has been fighting me here over the lands that I have. They are the same people. So, I reach out to one of the Balogun sons and I said, look, what is all this nonsense? For God's sake, this land belongs to Lagos State Government. We all got allocations that we bought from Lagos State Government. This doesn't belong to your father. But anyway, I have always in time past walked with you peacefully. I've given you millions of naira. Because I just believe I'm from the Niger Delta. I know what it is when you are fighting over land in our area. Okay? So let us not fight. Take 10 million naira. So that's how I used to, anytime they squirrel, I give them something. But it looks like they get used to the money now. And so they wanted more. So I said, okay, this time around, we're going to fight now, dirty, because I've been talking the language of peace with you, and then you want trouble. Finally, they said, okay, let's talk peace again. So I had to do that almost 15 million. Okay? But the truth is, I do that because I feel, instead of us to fight over money, let us shake hands. Okay? Instead of us to be fighting over Toro Kobo, peace is better than war. I didn't hear somebody. What did I say? If money is going to be the problem, we'll give the money and let us have peace with us. So that's what I've done. So I didn't go to Abuja. Before the people in Abuja now heard that we are already brothers and sisters. So they called me, hey, baby, baby, hey, baby. I said, relax, call your man. Don't call. Call the petitioner. When they call the petitioner, I don't know. Reverend is a good man. There's nothing wrong with this man. This man is a good man. And petition was cancelled. Now, in the case of Eriko, that's what he would have done. Okay, instead of going to the police, arresting the woman, putting the woman in jail. Now the man's hands are full. Now he's been sued for 500 million naira. He's suing for 5 billion naira. He's suing a woman that cannot... A woman that cannot afford 1 million naira, suing her for 5 billion. I wonder where the money will come from. And now the woman has sued him for 500 million. They are suing each other. It makes no sense. Madam, I'm sorry. Our tomatoes that you bought from the market is a bad one. It could be a fake one. There are a lot of fake products in the market. Let us look at the one you bought. So let's be sure if it's fake. Or okay, don't worry, madam. You know, we'll make it up to you. Let us send you a carton of one of our tomatoes, the good one, so that you can be enjoying that with your family. Wave your hand behind it. If I'm the one handling that game, oh God, look, don't worry. I send you one carton of tomatoes. Enjoy it. Amen. And then you will now go back to Facebook and say, ah, this company, they sold me one carton of tomatoes. And what is here is very, very good. Matter settled. Wisdom, profitable to direct. They advised that man badly, and now the man has problems. Even the federal government now is looking into his case. Now they're going to look into his tax. They're going to look at how he got his the ingredient for the tomatoes. They're going to go into how his grandmother became the father of his grandmother, wife of his grandfather. They're going to look at the village he came from. By the time they finish, he's going to cough us a serious amount of money. Are just certain things you don't do. Do you understand? I even expected this pastor also to try to help out. But if you lack wisdom, you need people that has wisdom to correct you. This is a disaster. Now the women are demonstrating all over Nigeria, saying that they should boycott his product. That nobody, no woman should cook with his product no more. All because of foolishness. He that have ears, let him hear. I want to help somebody this morning to realize that every form of spiritual weakness is not a reason to go to hell. What did I say? Help me, son. Say it with your mouth. It's not what? It's not a reason to go to hell. Amen? It's not a reason. You have made a mistake. You made certain choices in life that are wrong. But that does not mean you should die in your mistakes. Are you there? If I am this man, believe me, I withdraw my case from court, settle police, call the woman to my and smile. Madam, I'm sorry. Please. Oga, please beg your wife for me. I went the wrong direction. I was ill-advised. Okay? For the next 1 year, I supply all the tomatoes you'll be using in your house. And the news will enter television. I said, that man is a reasonable man. You can make me. Tell your neighbor you can make me.
You can make me.
Say it again.
You can make me.
And one thing you should not do. Mistake, I said. You can make mistakes.
Yes.
But one thing you should not do. Don't allow your mistake to destroy your life. Do you understand what I'm saying? Sin in the Garden of Eden was a mistake that Eve embraced. But God sought to correct it.
Yes,
there is always the place of correction.
Yes.
Right? Don't allow your ego, your stupidity, cost you your life all because you've made a mistake. Yes, you've made a mistake. Accept that you made a mistake and retrace your step and do what is right. And when you do that, you'll be blessed of God. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Am I talking to somebody here? Can we correct our mistakes? Can we do things better? Look at your life. If you think that you are going the wrong direction, my friend, retrace your steps. Tell yourself the truth. One of the biggest problems we have in this world is that we don't tell ourselves the truth.
Yes, sir.
Even when people are telling us the truth, we have problem with those telling us the truth. We fight truth. Any man that will be destroyed in this life is a man that will fight truth. Even when you are telling him that this is death here, I'm seeing death here, say, let me go and die. No problem. When we get to the bridge, we'll cross it. You will never get to the bridge. Ask your neighbor, have you made a mistake? You must not die in it. Say it, let me hear you. Say it again. Mistake can come with shame. Swallow the shame. What will people say? Let them say. Do you hear me? What are the people going to say about me? Let them say this about you. it is better for them to say that to go to hell. It is better for them to say that for you to die prematurely. Lose your life because of decisions you have made. Let them say, and you stay alive. If people here, if this world here, I am finished, you are not finished. A man that is finished is the one that goes to hell. Take a decision for your own good. He that have ears, let him hear. Finally, I share this with you and I'm close. Right and left. Say it with your mouth. Say it again. Right and left. Tell your neighbor, which side do you belong? Answer somebody there. Which side do you? Which side do you day? I day my day, you day your day. Where you day? Hello, somebody there. Am I talking to somebody? Now, let me share with you as we round up. Matthew chapter 25, verse 33, the test itself. The Bible says, when the Son, from verse 31, when the Son of Man shall come into his glory and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations. Know that word. And he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divided the sheep from the goats. Come on, somebody in the house of God. He, who is he? Jesus. He said, when he sits on his throne in heaven, he said his glorious throne with his holy angels on that throne, he said something is going to happen. The nations of the world shall all be gathered, meaning all man will face Christ one day. Every human being created by God will one day encounter Christ. But this is what will happen that day. The Bible said, on that fateful day, there will be separation of the goat from the sheep. The angels are going to go into the crowd and begin to say, hey, you, come to the right-hand side. Hey, you, go to the left-hand side. When that day happens, which side will they send you? Right or left? Right? Because the Bible says all nations will be gathered before him while he's seated on the white throne of judgment, on his throne of glory, and all the holy angels are seated with him. They are there for one thing, to separate the sheep from the goat. All the sheep, he will tell them, come where? Come to my right hand side. And all the goats will be sold to go where? Go to my left hand side. And that day, the decision will be made where you will be. Those who are going to the right hand side are commanded to go into heaven, where they will live with God for the rest of their lives. If I'm talking to you, you shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. If your name is going to be on the right hand, you shout another hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some of you are shouting as if you don't know where you'll be. But the hallelujah doesn't sound well. So you don't even know which side you'll be. If you know you'll be on the right hand, shout in hallelujah. If you are going to be on the left hand side, shout hallelujah. Do you see that? There is somebody that doesn't know where he's going. He's already shouting, ha! He said, ha! Before he realized, no! And then he didn't complete it. Oh, oh! Oh, for only ha! You shouldn't even think of it. Ha! It shouldn't come out of your mouth. On that day, this is not a laughing matter, my friends. Think about it. Think about it. Nations are gathered. Separation is taking place. To the right, to the left. To the right, to the left. To the right, to the left. Know it now. Once you are sent to the left, your own is finished. You cannot bribe anybody, my friend. It's not Nigerian police. You can't say you want to give money to anybody. It's not from Ghana, not from the US. Corruption of the police everywhere. There's nowhere in this world you don't see such. It's not only Nigeria. Can I hear somebody say amen? So the Bible said division will take place. And then he used the word, that's where right and left will be shown to people. And then he said, then shall the king say unto them on the right hand side, come, ye blessed of my father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Do you hear that? Do you hear that? Them who has been asked to come to the right hand side, the king who is the Lord Jesus Christ seated on his throne now said, to all them that are found on the right hand side, come ye blessed of my father. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of what? The world. And he said, for I was hungry and ye gave me meat. I was thirsty and ye gave me drink. I was a stranger and ye took me in. Naked and ye clothed me. I was sick and ye visited me. I was in prison and ye came unto me. Then shall the righteous answer him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee hungry and fed thee, or thirsty and gave thee drink? When saw we thee a stranger and took thee in, naked and clothed thee? Oh, when saw we thee sick or in prison and came unto thee? And the king shall answer and say unto them, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of my least of these brethren, ye have done it unto me. Now notice. Then he shall say unto them on the left hand. Come on. Look at that. Depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. That will not be your portion. Do you hear what I say? What did I say? That will not be your portion. You are not going to hell. Stand up and point your hand to somebody and tell that person, you are not going to hell. Say it again to somebody there. Repeat that word. You are not going to hell. Look, my friends. My name is Edward Benson. Know this today. I am a man who took a decision. And the Lord felt the decision I took was wrong. And revealed it to me 2 days before I took the decision. I slept at night and I was in a thick forest. And there was an ocean behind the thick forest. What happened in that thick forest? I just could not lay my hand on it. But I knew I woke up troubled and sweating. And I was about to take a decision 2 days. So I realized, my God, what have I done? But I have done a lot of things to prepare. So I decided I'm not going to cancel my decisions. Even when the Lord has made me realize, this is what it is. My spirit man was troubling me inside. But even as I was being troubled inside, and God has revealed to me, and God spoke a word 2 days before. I was in this altar to pray at night. I came here around 9 o'clock, alone by myself. I lie down here on this, for 1 hour I was crying to God, Lord, I'm about to make one of the biggest decisions of my life. I need you now to talk to me. Once I finished praying, it led me straight to Isaiah chapter 54, verse 4. I read it from verse 4 to verse 10 in this altar. And the Lord said to me, the mistake of your youth, you will not make it again. And the shame that came to you in your youth, that shame I will take away from you. I read it and said, Father, what do you mean by this? And I read it down. And the Spirit of God ministered to me what he said. that scripture word. Meaning, what I show you in the night is the same thing I'm telling you now. But I still went ahead to say, okay, Father, this is too, you know, there are certain lines when you cross them, you don't want to go back. You cross some line and you like, damn it, let me see to the end. But you know, our Father, He's a mighty God. When He says, you are not going to hell, you are not going to hell. You don't understand. When God put His leg down and say, friend, I have a covenant with you. It's a covenant of peace. Read it. It's there. He said to me, down. Verse 10 or 11. I have a covenant of peace with you. And I will not allow anyone to steal your peace. So He put His foot down. And every night from that day, this one saw a vision. The other one saw a vision. The other one saw a vision. Visions were coming all over the place. There were visions everywhere. And the visions were coming to my ears. Thus saith the Lord. I slept yesterday and I saw this. I was preaching on Tuesday in this church. I said a word and a woman raised up his hand. Then he raised up his hand again and I refused to take the hand. Because when I'm preaching, when you raise up your hand, unless you prophesy, I won't call you. If you prophesy and the Holy Ghost wants me to hear your prophecy, I'll bring you out. But I can't be ministering, you raise up your hand. What do you want to do? Interrupt the ministration? So I didn't take it. And I have somebody that came from America that came to visit. I wanted to see the person before I cancel people. So I did that and I came back. The person just entered my office and said, sir, I had a vision yesterday night. This is what I saw. I told my husband we will not rest until we see you. So we came to see you together. Man of God. Thus saith the Lord. I said, I know. The Lord has shown me these things and spoken to me. I know. On Sunday, I decided to go to the mountain. I said, Father, speak to me so that I know. I don't want to take a decision and then I regret it. I want you to speak. So I picked my partners and we went to the mountain to fast and pray for 3 days. We never fasted and prayed for 3 days, only one day. And God opened the heavens and began to show all manner of things. And then finally, He spoke to me by 5:30 in the morning. 2 Samuel chapter 22, verse 14. I read it down. 21. Decision was taken. The Lord said, I turned that from the heavens, uttered my voice in heaven. Every revelation you see was an utterance that came from me. I wanted you to know the mount of diverse persons. I turned that my voice from the heavens and make known my voice to men so that you know that which is my will. You have a strong enemy and I've delivered you from the enemy's hands. See, let me tell you one thing about this God that we serve. He will never allow you to go to hell when you are a heavenly candidate. I pray God will torment some of you so that you will never make hell. You didn't say a good amen to that. I pray God will torment your flesh, torment your spirit, torment your soul so that you don't go to hell. Because it is better for you to be tormented by God to make heaven than for you to be enjoying tapioca and be enjoying watermelon and be enjoying snail pizza and all the vegetation that comes with it, and you end up where? In hell. That will be your portion. You enjoy and you please the flesh. The flesh is enjoying. Your soul is going to suffer in hell. Know it today that it's better for your flesh to suffer here and your soul saved in heaven. He that have ears, let him hear. Finally, here is it. When you get this, this will help you. And this is how this matter will be settled this morning. And what is it? Matthew 27, verse 38. Matter is settled. Look, the cross of Jesus Christ of Nazareth had made it clear that on that cross, there were two thieves. He was in the middle, but there were two thieves. There was a thief on the left-hand side, and there was a thief where? Matthew 27 verse what? 38. There were two thieves crucified with him. One of them were thieves. Make no mistake about it. So what it means is that all of us here, we're all thieves. We're all sinners. Everybody here is what? There's no right to everybody. Don't deceive yourself. We are, if God look into your righteousness, he will find fault. We sin with our thoughts. We sin with what we say. We sin with our eyes. We even sin with our ears. We sin with our hearts. We imagine vain things. We bear false witness against people. We lie and cheat and do all kinds of things. But because of what Jesus did on the cross, all of such things we have done has been canceled, nullified by the power of the blood of his son. But make no mistake about it, your righteousness is not what is taking you to heaven. It is what Jesus did on the cross that is covering you today. And that's why you are going to make it. I didn't hear somebody say amen. So there were two thieves on the cross. One to the right, one to the left. The Bible said the one on the left hand refused to acknowledge the person of Jesus and accused him of all sorts of things. If you be the Son of God, command us to leave this cross and come down from the cross. You heal the sick. You save those who are afflicted. Save us if you be the Son of God. He opened his mouth and began to blaspheme. But the thief on the right hand side, you know, those on the right hand side knows what to say. In time of trouble, they will say the right words. May you have the right words to say.
Amen.
I didn't hear somebody say amen.
Amen.
Hello, somebody there. Hello, somebody there. Our reasoning is different from them on the left. The way they think on the left is different than the way we think on the right hand side. The right hand side thief said, will you shut your mouth? This man you see here is a righteous man. He has done nothing. How did he know? There is always the spirit of God in them on the right hand side. The spirit of truth is with them on the right hand side. The spirit of discernment is with them on the right hand side. They know what to say and what not to say. They know when to shut their mouth and when to open their mouth. Come on, somebody in the house of God. So he said, Jesus, thou son of David, remember me when you come to your kingdom. He also know that Jesus has a kingdom. So there are two people here. Those who know there's a kingdom and those who don't know there's a kingdom. I ask you a question. Do you know there's a kingdom? Do you know there is a kingdom? Because that will determine where you are going. This man on the left-hand side does not even know there's a kingdom anywhere. I'm sure he didn't even hear there's hell somewhere. Like some of you here who deny the fact that there's no hell. Let me make it clear. There is hell. If there's no hell, then where is the devil going? If there's no hell, where did God cast him to? There is hell and there's a heaven. So don't deny yourself of heaven or hell. Am I talking to somebody here? Are you listening to the sound of my voice? We've made mistakes, but our mistakes will not destroy us. We will retrieve our steps and do what is right in the sight of God. We will say no to Satan and say yes to God. Am I talking to somebody here? He that have ears, let him hear. So what happened? The thief on the left hand side died and went to hell, and the thief on the right hand side did what? Died and was taken to paradise. It's either you're on the left or you're on the right. Everybody stand. Hallelujah. Who is on the right hand side? 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 You are the one the Bible said you are blessed. You are the one the Bible promised eternal life. You are the one God used his hand to prepare a mansion for you in heaven. You are the one that have a different story in your life. You are the one that the cross has meaning for. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Are you there, somebody there? You have a bright future because you are making heaven. Oh, you have a bright future because you are making heaven. You are not going to hell. You will not die and perish. You have eternal life. For the love of God is for them who are going to have eternal life. This love is for them. Come on, somebody. The love of God is for them who will end up in heaven. Now I came here to tell you, during this season of Easter, please reflect on your decisions. Reflect. Even when people were trying to talk me to, no, you've taken a decision. You've done this, you've done that. I said, which decision? Is it a decision God made or a decision I made? I recount what I say and I hold on to what God said. I don't care who you are. I don't care where you came from. When God says run, I run. When God says stand, I stand. When God says sit, I sit. He said jump, I jump. But I will never listen to any voice contrary to the voice of God. Jesus said unto him, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that cometh out of the mouth of the Father. Every word that cometh out of the mouth of the Father. Live by the things that come from him. Am I talking to somebody there? Because those on the right hand side always listen to him. And those on this side, they are stubborn. They always listen to their master. And their master also is on the left hand side. Where do you find Jesus? Where do you find Jesus? Where do you find the devil? I didn't hear you talk to me. Where do you find Jesus? Where do you find the devil? And where are you? Where are you? Where am I? Where is your neighbor? Where are your enemies? On the left hand side. The devil is their master. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. If you are here this morning, you've not given your life to Jesus, believe me, I'm going to pray a prayer with you. Pray it where you are. And if you are here, you're on the left hand side, you want to move to the right hand side, believe me, there's a prayer for you. And so let us stand. Say after me, Lord Jesus, I know who I am. I am not a righteous man. I'm a filthy sinner. I have made mistakes in my life, but I've made up my mind. My mistakes will not destroy my life. They will not kill me. They will not rob me of the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, oh God, every mistake I have made in my life, forgive me, oh God, and give me a second chance to make the right decisions that will bring me to heaven, that will translate me from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. Jesus, my master, my savior, you are the only one who was standing with the Father at the right-hand side. All of us were on the left-hand side, but you went to the cross and you decided by the essence of the cross, you took us from the left-hand side and you brought us to the right-hand side. Jesus, thank you for the right-hand side experience. Today, oh God, I surrender to you. May I not die and go to hell. I don't belong to hell. Heaven is my portion. Is the dwelling place of God. The Savior dwells there, and I'll be with him forever. Lord, have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Forgive me, oh God, for every mistake every sin, every transgression that I've ever committed, every form of disobedience against your holy name. Thank you, my Father, for a second chance. Thank you, oh God, for removing me from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. Amen. May the Lord bless you. Welcome to the right-hand side. May God bless you. It is well with you, my friends. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah. Are you blessed this morning? Tell somebody, welcome to the right hand side. Glory to Jesus. Who is he that speaks and come to pass when the Lord has not spoken? So once God has spoken, and twice have I heard it, that the power belongs to God. Hallelujah. He said, the Lord has given a word, and great is the company of them that publish the word. Hallelujah. So much great word we have heard this morning. It is not much about what happened to man that matters, but how you undo what happened to you. That's the difference in man. So much lessons for us to learn today. The right side of God symbolizes power, authority, and it guarantees heaven, more importantly. I